perspective, dignitaries on the dais, the president, secretary, and the organizing committee, and my colleague and friend Gopinath, and many others whom I have known over years working in cardiac anesthesia. It gives me great pleasure today to be with you all in this hall and the gathering. In the sense, sometimes I am lucky, because most of the people tell me I am lucky, but sometimes the luck also comes and then it, hits the hand at the door. Like this Marriott may be lucky for me, in the sense I was telling Gopi, that last time we had the ISCCM South Zone Conference, and Devi Shetty was supposed to deliver the oration, and he couldn't come. So then they asked me, "Madam, please address, because you are the one who brought critical care in this part of the country." So then today, Gopi came home and said, "Madam, you have to come." So I can never say no to Gopi, so I said, "Okay, I'll go ahead and come here." And then suddenly he says, "You have to do more because you are the chief yesterday." Well, anyway, that's what I'm saying. Today, I think cardiac anesthesia has grown leaps and bounds. You do so much work with the patient, the pump or not the pump, or with the surgeons, and you have become a part and parcel of the great teams which you all formed. And this all dates back to a long time before this, when all of us started working in cardiac anesthesia in the early 80s. So don't guess my age, it's okay, even if you guess, it's fine. So in the 80s, there was hardly anything in this city. So it started in Gandhi Hospital, and there was a surgeon who was very tough surgeon and very meticulous and very, very focused on giving the care to the patient in a government hospital. So this is what is the... So when I was working there, I just came back from Iran, and then I was working in a chest hospital doing a lot of lung cases. Somehow, from the very beginning, from my All India Institute days, I always gravitated towards cardiac anesthesia. Maybe in those days, we used to do a lot of open heart surgeries in the late 60s and 70s, early 70s, with Professor Gopinath, is your same name. He was the cardiac surgeon, very well known in those days. So he has started a good unit, and many people got trained under him as cardiac surgeons, many of our people too. So this paved the way. When I was as a resident, I used to be sort of thrilled to work. If anybody said, "I don't want to go for the cardiac, you know, the surgeon is shouting too much, so I don't like it," I said, "Okay, I will go. It's okay. If he shouts, maybe I will learn, or if I am bold enough, I will tell him a little bit of answer back." So with this sort of a background, I came here, and then we did in Gandhi Hospital. I must say, in a setup of government, we did really have good setup. We used to do more cases of valves and, constrictive pericarditis and mitral valve, aortic valve, TOF, and these sort of things we did. But we never did the CABG in those days. And as luck would have it, I came to Nizam's. So there was already a cardiac surgical unit. And they used to do one case a day with two or three, they had about two theaters. So we slowly developed, and then people joined me in a year or two. All these younger people from different institutes came, and we never looked back. So by the time I left, we were doing a large number of almost six cases per day, and all sorts of cases we were doing. The only thing which I felt I couldn't get was the TEE, and the cardiologist did not want to give it at that time. Okay, so that was... And now you have it, I really feel happy, And we do use lot of echo in our own ICUs now. So that has made me feel quite happy that I push people to learn echo even in the ICU. We don't usually call cardiologist unless it is really necessary to say, okay, that chapa has to be there, okay? So this has progressed so much, and I think around 98, Varanasi, yeah, that is the conference in the ISA. In all ISA meetings, we used to have one-day program for cardiac anesthesia. So we used to take care of that. Many of us who are interested, maybe my age group, I don't think I see anybody here. But we had one Professor P.N. Bhatt, whose oration you have here. And so we all sat down and then say, let us have a group separate from this ISA, because we are not able to be very academic there. We are becoming more political there. So I think that is the reason we have sort of come out. And if you all remember, I don't know if it is still there, even in the cardiac surgical also you have about half day or one day program. I don't know whether it is there, whether you are all going or not, but it was there. So we used to do that too. Once we have started our own, and with the journal and with all the younger people taking so much, it has greatly improved. And I am so happy to see so many of you practicing cardiac anesthesia, which has been my really very close to my heart, because it's cardiac anesthesia anyway. So that is what over the period you have built it, and it has gone on very smoothly. The only thing I would like to say as an elder, of course, the president already said these things, recent times, with so much of privatization and so many things, we are slowly losing the empathy for the patient. I think without empathy, the doctor is, I feel, is useless. If you have no empathy for your patient, and that means you are not really a good doctor. So that should not be lost. Second thing, you are becoming more and more very addicted to, like, your phone, to the technology. I'm not saying don't use it. Everybody will tell you that I was the first one to get the things and use in my place even today. But kindly look at the clinical aspect also and then see. Many times I ask, okay, now tell me, can you write down how the the arterial pulse looks like in aortic regurge, or looks like in a septic shock, or looks like in the normal? Can you write? Many of the students will not write because they do not focus their attention at the pulse wave. They will only say systolic, mean, fine. I mean, this is what we have learned so much from the pulse wave, which has given us a number of things. So I request the youngsters, please keep your eyes open and maybe mouth shut for a little while, but learn these things keeping your eyes open and your ears open. So these things will help you, because in those days we didn't have that much technology, but we used to see a lot sitting beside the patient. So if you are in the, as you were saying, that pediatric cardiac surgical units, so you have to be a pediatrician, you have to be a surgeon, you have to be a cardiac anesthetist, and you have to be the administrator. You have to be the comforter, you have to be the communicator at that particular time. Others are not there. You are the main person who is running the show. So when you have to do this, my sincere advice is go a little bit more in-depth into physiology, learn from there, from the basics, and build your own thing. Yes, guidelines are there to help you. You ask anyone nowadays, there is a guideline. 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B. But what are you doing at the bedside? Is it helping you or is it not helping you? So unless you focus your attention there, the guideline will be there in your brain. You may not be utilizing it at the bedside. So I don't want to prolong this, because then you will say, what is this old woman going on and on? So What I am trying to say is, there is another thing he was saying, that people don't like to stay for longer time or do the multitasking. These are the two things. See, as a woman, we multitask quite a bit compared to men. Okay, many men may not agree, but I don't care. But this is the nature, right? So, if you are multitasking, you have to prioritize what is that you are multitasking about. That is the most important thing. So, another thing is that you are not liking to spend any time more than what it depends. Suppose the patient is really sick and your being there would make a difference, you stay. That is your conscience. So, I won't say you have to balance the life which is not your profession and the life. Otherwise, your children will go haywire in this particular time where there is so much on the net, so much on the phone, so much on the media. So, you have to balance. So, once you balance, and you will be happy. So, I wish you all the happiness with the profession and with your lives, and do a good job. Thank you.